Saludos, mi gente, Rafi, Media Vía de Criticolores. Continuamos en Comic Fest Aguada con 2019. Y esta vez me encuentro con una individua que yo estaba loco por hablar con ella. Because of how many the covers stuff that you've done from DC and Marvel, specifically Wonder Woman, obviously. Jenny Frison, welcome to Criticolores.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
First time here in Puerto Rico?
Yes, first time.
And then you come to the West Side, which is cool. Because I was talking to Renee, and I was like, people don't get to come to the West Side of Port the Island. Everybody goes to the Metro Side, and it's always, to me, it's really interesting and fun when you get to see a different side of the island. How's it been your staying here?
It's been beautiful. Everyone has been really kind and welcoming. We definitely want to come back for a longer vacation so we can see more of the island. We flew into San Juan, so we got to see the drive from San Juan to the West Side here, and it's great. It's been awesome.
It's good. So, okay. Marvel and DC, obviously you're mostly known for Wonder Woman and your different covers for her, but also you have worked with Marvel. What is the difference between working with Marvel and DC?
Oh, I mean, besides literally different people, a lot There's of...
Structure-wise, maybe.
Well, so for DC, I mostly do variant covers, which the difference between a main cover and a variant cover, usually I can be more creative with the variant cover. It does not have to be about what is happening in that particular issue. With the main covers, usually have to be real story specific. So I don't know. I would say just based on the fact that I'm doing variants for DC covers, I usually get to be more creative and more just like an iconic image of Wonder Woman rather than Wonder Woman fighting this particular character, because that's what happens in that issue.
So you can say that when you're doing your DC comics, they're more of yourself in those covers than when you do the Marvel ones, but there's more structure. There's more, they want you to go a certain way.
Sure,
right.
Yeah.
Right. What would be one of the most difficult covers to do? What gave you the most trouble to complete?
Oh, I have no idea. I don't know. I mean, they're all a little hard, right?
But you didn't have anyone, a specific one that told you, I really didn't like what I was doing. I want to do something else.
Oh, well, I mean, so for Wonder Woman specifically, my editor has been very open to any idea, and he almost never says no to a concept. But there was one concept I wanted to pitch for the, I don't remember what issue it was now, but the one that has... Wonder Woman and Supergirl eating ice cream and enjoying a fine day together. I initially tried to pitch an homage to an old World's Finest cover where Batman and Superman are playing basketball, and I wanted to do Wonder Woman and Supergirl playing basketball.
That's cool.
But they didn't want
that's
to do...
That's cool.
Yeah, he
that's
was like...
That's cool. I'm sorry, but
it,
that's,
I was really excited
that's
about
really
it.
Cool.
And I was sure I'd do it, and I sent them the sketch, and they're like, oh, we don't really want to do homage covers. What else do you have? And I was like, aw.
No, I'm with you. Because it's diversity. It's more of this. I mean,
I'm glad he said no, because I really like that cover of them eating ice cream together. I think it turned out much better.
Yeah. I remember that cover. Yeah.
Just as a cover, I think it's better. But also, it's a lot more about like, you know, just women having fun together. And the other one would have just been about basketball, I guess.
Yeah, but you're right.
But it was, I liked the idea of doing like a vintage homage cover to like something specific. But
exactly. Let's talk a little bit about the process. Do you stick to pencil and pen, or are you going digital? I'm asking you this because a bunch of people are going like, I'm using the iPad, I'm using something else, I'm sticking to the times.
So I do about half and half traditional and digital. I draw everything in pencil on white paper. And then I print it out on this gray tone paper, and I do like all the rendering is done by hand, but all in gray tones with marker and paint and chalk and graphite. And then I scan them both and lay them together in Photoshop, and all the colors are Photoshop, but all of the rendering is done by hand.
That's cool. So one final question. If somebody has seen this interview right now, aspiring artist and wants to get the ball rolling on this, what would be your number one suggestion?
Well, if you're interested in art and you want to work in comics, my biggest suggestion is draw all the time. The more you can draw, the faster you can draw. The turnarounds for comics are very fast, so the faster you can draw, the more practice that you can get now, the better. They always say, I don't know who said it, but there's like 10,000 bad drawings in all of us, and if you can get them all out in the beginning, then you're going to be great after that. And then if you're already like starting to look for work and further along in your career, get stuff online, take stuff to conventions, try to meet artists, writers, and editors, and just try to be reliable and pleasant, mm-hmm. and also obviously talented.
That's important. Yeah, the attitude is pretty important. Jenny, thank you, and good luck on everything. I love your work.
I'm not
kidding. I love her work. Thank you. Aquí estamos y seguimos aquí en Criticólogos. No se vaya nadie.